Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a load of updates once again today, starting with the recent launch of Starlink 18 with another 60 satellites. The booster which launched B1060 landed for the fifth time, having flown less than 1 month prior, a great turnaround time.
Able to stick this landing. Looks pretty good. There we can see the first stage has landed. This marks the...
Tweeting about the landing of B1060, Musk posted saying this was a tough one. In response to that, Everyday Astronaut asked, what made it tough? Did you guys expand the envelope again on landing conditions or performance? Musk responded and said, high seas and wind. SpaceX posted a tweet saying they were moving the launch of Starlink 17 to Sunday to give themselves additional time. However, on Friday, they then posted another tweet delaying the launch further once again. They said, standing down from this weekend's launch attempt of Starlink from LC-39A for additional inspections before flying one of our fleet-leading boosters as the team continues to drive toward a separate Falcon 9 launch of Starlink from SLC-40 at the end of next week. Thought I'd share this really cool shot SpaceX posted on Twitter. You can see the Starlink 17 Falcon 9 stack in the foreground as another Falcon 9 launches Starlink 18 in the background. On the topic of Starlink, CNBC posted an article recently which says SpaceX disclosed in a public filing on Thursday that its Starlink satellite internet service now has over 10,000 users in the United States and abroad. There's another article, this one from Ars Technica, about information released in a recent FCC filing. The article says a new SpaceX filing outlines plans for Starlink to offer phone services, emergency backup for voice calls, and cheaper plans for people with low incomes through the government's Lifeline program. SpaceX have posted about another mission they are going to be launching in the coming years. They said Falcon 9 will launch NASA's Sphere X mission, which will collect data on more than 300 million galaxies and explore how the universe began from our launch site at Vandenberg Air Force Base as early as June 2024. With Boca Chica stuff, new super heavy ground support equipment was spotted. For Starship, a new thrust dome was spotted having been sleeved. A new upper bulkhead was also spotted on the sleeving mount. SpaceX were previously building a Mark II prototype in Florida before dismantling it. John Winkup has posted some shots of some interesting components spotted at the same site. He said they are building something cool at the SpaceX Sidco Road site. Can it fit inside the cargo section of a Starship? Last picture in the top section before being attached in first to pictures. SpaceX have begun dismantling SN5, they were seen cutting away at it. Rest in pieces, SN5, you did good. SN7.2, made from new 3mm steel, was pressure tested for the second time. This test, though, was to destruction. With some SN8 news, there are a couple of tweets from Christian Davenport. The first says, some congressional staffers were briefed yesterday on the SpaceX FAA launch license violation. They were told there was a miscommunication on modelling for how far any shockwave would travel from a blast and the damage it would cause, i.e. broken windows in changing weather. Then he also posted, given the communication problem, FAA investigated not only the SN8 hard landing but also did a comprehensive review of the company's safety culture, operational decision making and process discipline. The investigation was done quickly and changes were incorporated for SN9. By now, you'll all know of SN9's launch to 10 kilometers in altitude. You'll also know about its subsequent demise. Here's a view of some of the wreckage. Musk posted SN9 with the text pull up on Twitter with the caption, next time we try pull up method. Somebody responded and asked, why only light two engines for landing? Any engine failure means loss of vehicle, so you have two single points of failure. Why not light all three, do the flip, then pick the best two and turn off the other? Musk then said we were too dumb. In relation to this, Musk posted a tweet in response to Everyday Astronaut. He said it was foolish of us not to start three engines and immediately shut down one as two are needed to land. He was then asked, will these changes be able to be implemented into the SN10 test flight, to which he responded yes. In another tweet, Musk was asked, wouldn't it be safer to light free and throttle free for landing just in case there's one engine failure? He responded with yes, but engines have a minimum throttle point where there is flame out, so landing on free engines means high thrust to weight further away from hover point, which is also risky. In response, he was asked, so it would be determined which to cut off based on data available right after relight. Musk responded and said, yeah, by default, engine with least lever arm should shut down if all three are good. In relation to that tweet, Brendan Lewis made and posted a diagram to demonstrate what Elon Musk meant. Musk responded with yes. With even more tweets, Everyday Astronaut asked Musk, someday the leverage arm won't matter as much when you go to hot gas thrusters though, right? He responded with, intuitively it would seem so, but turbopump-fed Raptors have higher thrust and propellant mass friction than pressure-fed gas thrusters and they are already there. In response to that, he also added higher ISP too. Musk added some more info with, that said, the ship landing burn has a clear solution. My greatest concern is achieving good payload to orbit with rapid and full reusability, without which we shall forever be confined to Earth. Musk was also asked, so does that mean for the time being you'll be sticking with cold gas RCS? He said, we'll still use hot gas maneuvering thrusters as approximately 5 times more efficient than nitrogen 300 second versus 60 second ISP. SpaceX moved Raptor engine SN50 to the launch pad to be installed onto SN10. They've also recently moved SN39 to be installed on SN10 too. Looking at possible SN10 testing, Cameron County has posted some road and beach closures. There's a primary date of Monday 8th, then another primary of Wednesday 10th. Plus, there are backup dates of Thursday 11th and Friday 12th, so hopefully we'll see some SN10 testing. SN11's nose was continuing to be worked on. As they get closer to stacking, the SN11 tank was moved into the high bay. SN16's leg skirt with the legs extended was seen rolling into a tent. SN18's upper bulkhead has also been spotted. To finish up the video, we once again have the latest Starship and Super Heavy build diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Girl going out all day every day to film the awesome Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, livestreams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.